Over the festive period, a serious criminal offence of metal theft took place along Madeira Terraces. Mark Walker took up the story and spoke to the public to gauge their reaction.
So we're here at Madeira Terraces along Brighton seafront, and the reason is because over the festive period there was a substantial amount of metal theft from Madeira Terraces. And as you can see from the roofs here along here, there's been copper and steel and other metals have been stolen from the building. So we're going to be catching up with some local residents to see what their views are on about not just the metal theft, but more importantly about saving Madeira Terraces, because there's been a long-running campaign within our city to get these terraces restored, and this latest metal theft is just the latest in a series of setbacks really, which the council has been urged to try and address. So as you can see, there's now the terraces are barricaded up, there's a fence behind them, and there's no restoration work currently being taken place. We're going to find out the views from some local residents and see where we go from here.
We've lived here all our lives, you know, and it's gradually deteriorated over the years, but it's got to such a state now where it obviously needs a lot of money spent on it, and it's just, can the council come up with the money for it?
Being a Brighton resident, you're quite ashamed because it looks so rough, and now you've told me that some's been stolen. I mean, yeah, it's terrible. I mean, they won't get caught, will they? And it'll be flogged off somewhere. I don't know what to say about that, really. I mean, what can they do?
I just don't understand, because they were aware that it was copper and lead, and those things get stolen very easily. So I don't understand why the council haven't protected it, haven't had some sort of security around it, because it's well known that that material is stolen. To have something like this on the seafront is an amazing thing that we should protect. So absolutely, I can't see that anybody would disagree with that. Or it would cost money, but it's well worth it. It's a seaside resort. Tourism is big business. It attracts people. So why not? To have something like this is an amazing thing that lots of seaside towns don't have and should protect.
I don't know what they expect, like, if you're just going to leave it lying around, people are just going to start nicking bits off it, so.
Yeah,
like, further down they're making commercial use of it, so why not just carry it along further?
Yeah, I mean, I don't live in Brighton, but seeing like this is not really nice, so I guess they could do something to improve it, definitely.
I think the main thing for me is I'd like to see it become more of a sort of a as a covered walkway, something more than that, maybe a bit something for that creates a bit of community. So, you know, there might be space for market stalls or something that, yeah, something sort of open air that that gets people coming down here, spending time together down here, because as it is, it's
how it used to be.
Yeah, it's just right now it's just quite bare, and there's not much to it at the moment. I mean, right now it's very much a place for going from A to B. People come down, they walk along the seafront, and unless they're actually going down to the sea to stop there, you know, you come down here because you're in transit, or, you know, you've got some time, so you want to go for a stroll. But it would be really amazing to have a place where you could actually go and spend some time rather than just be on the move.
We love Brighton, and it is a shame that it's not becoming so nice as it was, although we don't want to move, do we? We do still love it, but it's deteriorated a lot and seems to be deteriorated a lot in the last 10, 15 mm-hmm. years.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, with the homeless, which I know is awful,
yeah.
Terrible for the homeless, but I don't know, just nothing seems to be done.
So there you have it. We've been speaking to local residents and tourists about the state of disrepair of the Madeira Terraces, particularly the metal theft over the festive period. We'll be keeping you posted on that news story. I'm Mark Walker, the news editor at Latest TV News. Back to you, Yael, in the studio.